shows us why. Angie?
Well, Kevin, the reason is there's a skills gap, and bridging that gap will require those who are looking for work to update or learn new skills.
Finding skilled workers to fill technical positions continues to be a challenge for some employers, according to Iowa workforce development officials, even though thousands of Iowans are still out of a job.
We're having a big gap there. We have an overabundance of people who are at the low skill level and an overabundance of jobs at the middle skill level, and they're not connecting right now. We need people to get additional training and upskilling.
The fact that there are jobs available in Iowa and growth in several industries like financial services and business professional are reasons for optimism. Iowa's unemployment rate of 5.2% is the fourth lowest in the nation, but Kuntz says it's cautious optimism.
We don't want to say that, yes, we're in a straight growth pattern here. You know, the unemployment rate's going down. We're getting less claims filed, new claims filed every month.
But those claims don't always tell the full story. Kuntz says because the unemployment rate is based on those who are working or actively seeking work, there's a segment of the unemployed that falls through the cracks.
So if you aren't looking for work anymore, you're not even considered part of the labor force to be counted. So it gets very difficult to define that.
And the number also doesn't take into account those who are underemployed. Kuntz says the fact that Iowa is and has consistently been below the national unemployment rate says a lot about the strong mix of business.
We've got strong in manufacturing, strong financial, strong agriculture. And if you think about some of your coastal states that get very heavily based into one type of an industry, we're able to weather some of that a little better because of our diversification.
Also factoring into this employment equation, Kuntz says many businesses are hesitant to make any major employment changes right now until after the election, so that could have an impact on the employment rate for the end of the year and the beginning of next year.
All right, Angie, thank you very much.